Hello and welcome to today's videos on how to create Mailbox Database in Exchange 2016. Mailbox Database is a major component of Exchange 2016. Exchange Mailbox Database is EDB file that contains data, data definitions, checksums, flags and other information that make up a mailboxes. It is the database file where all the mailbox are stored. Exchange uses extensible storage engine as its database engine. When emails comes into Exchange server, the email first comes into memory, then it comes into transaction logs, and then the email is stored into Exchange database. Transaction logs files of a particular database record all the transactions performed on a database. Different set of transaction log files are created for different database. You can create multiple mailbox database which will create multiple EDB files and different set of transaction log files. So let's see how we can create a mailbox database on Exchange 2016. So first of all, you have to open Exchange Admin Center. Let's log in as an administrator. In Exchange Admin Center, click on Servers. Under Server, you will find your Exchange server. In our case, it is x16-mbx01. Now click on Databases. And under that, you will see one mailbox database name, mailbox database, and some random numbers are there. When you perform clean installation of Exchange 2016, a default mailbox database is created automatically in default Exchange installation location, and that is, let's click on edit, and as you can see, the database path is C program files Microsoft Exchange Server v15 mailbox and the name of your mailbox database. So this is the default location of your Exchange mailbox database. Similarly, a set of transaction log files are also created in the same directory. Click on cancel. It is highly recommended that you create a mailbox database in a drive other than the system drive. When you create a mailbox database in Exchange 2016, you also need to specify log folder path. So let's create a mailbox database, and to do that, you have to click on this plus sign. Now specify the name of your mailbox database. Now let's specify the name of your mailbox database. For example, let's specify MDB01 as a mailbox database name. Now let's select the server where you want to create the new mailbox database. Let's click on browse. And in our Exchange organization, we have a single mailbox server, and that is EX16-MBX01. Let's select it. And this is the default location of our mailbox database. That will be C program file Microsoft Exchange Server v15 mailbox and then your name of your mailbox database. Let's open a C drive. On the C drive, click on program files. In the program file, click on Microsoft and Exchange Server v15 and mailbox. So this is the folder for our default mailbox database, and now we are going to create another mailbox database on the same location, and it will be also automatically mount. Click on save. See, it is best practice to store database files and logs in a different drives. Transaction logs can come handy while recovering the Exchange database. Okay, and it is gives us one message. Please restart the Microsoft Exchange Information Store service on this server after adding a new mailbox database. Click on OK. And as you can see, now we have another mailbox database named MDB01 on our local server, and the status of this mailbox database is mounted. Now let's see the location of default Exchange mailbox database. Under this location, now we have another mailbox named MDB01. Now as you can see, there is a transaction log files with the extension of .log. Like as you can see, we have a E01. These are the actual transaction log files that stores all the transactions performed on a database. Transaction means all the read or write operations performed on a database. All information are stored in logs before writing them into the database. This is because if database error occurs or if database is corrupted, then the database can be recovered from these transaction log files. The database can be restored from transaction log files if circular login is not enabled. These are 1 MB in a size. The name of the files are in a hexadecimal. For example, as you can see, our log file name is E01 and then the numbers. Now another, we have one more file, E01.chk. This is the checkpoint file, keeps the track of transaction already written to database. If circular logging is enabled, transaction logs that are already written to the database are deleted, creating a free space on a particular trail. Now, we have a temporary database, and that is the temp.edb. It is temporary database where transaction files are processed. And then we have an action server reserved transaction log files, and these are the .grs file. These reserved transaction log files are placeholders and are used only when the DAO runs out of the space. You know, a lot of heavy work is done in a log folder location, so make sure the storage volume for log files is different from the database storage location. The storage also have high read and write speed. Make sure volume that hosts transaction log have a free space and avoid using circular logging features. So this is the way how we can create a mailbox database in Exchange 2016 by using GUI method. So in the next video, we'll see how to rename a mailbox database, and we will see how to move an Exchange Server 2016 mailbox database to another location. That's it for this video demonstration. Thanks for watching this video.